Hello everyone, this is Ben at Russound. I'm going to give you a taste today of IR capability on the MCA-Series. So I'd like to set up a Blu-ray disc player here for you, show you the steps as I'm doing it, and then demonstrate how you can control the Blu-ray player through Russound. We've got a few options for that, such as IR pass-through using the original remote and one of our MDK or SLK-1 keypads. You also have the option of using My Russound through either your smartphone, tablet, or our XTS and XTS Plus keypads as well. So we're going to give you the basic 101 on IR control with MCA Series. So our first order of business here is to make a few simple connections. For that, we're going to go to the rear of this setup here. And by the way, I have an MCA 66 and just a simple Blu-ray player here. No major connections have been made. I don't have any actual inputs or sources yet, so this just allows me to have a nice clean back of the MCA to show you here. We do have a keypad, of course. I'd like to show you an MDK C6 keypad wired into this, ultimately to show you that control. We always, of course, need our network and our power, so that's, of course, here. What I have here is an IR emitter. So we will need to make a connection between the back of the MCA and the IR receiver on the front of the Blu-ray player. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. Now let's get up nice and close here on the MCA. You'll notice that we have a section for routed IR outputs. On the case of the MCA 66, they're labeled 1 through 6. Also a common output. These routed IR outputs are specific to the source. So if we go through the programming and we want to set up our Blu-ray disc player here for, say, source 1, then we'll need to make sure that we're using an IR emitter plugged into routed IR output number 1. The common output is sending a common IR signal out, so this will always be sending out an IR command. So basically, if I have, let's say, Blu-ray disc player here, number 1, I have an altogether different device, a CD player, number 2, and then maybe I have a second Blu-ray player, and maybe that's source 3, but maybe I'm using the common here. If I'm physically selecting source number 1 on a keypad or the app, the command will be outputted through both IR output 1 as well as the common. If I switch over to source 2, it's going to be only source 2, but it's still also the common. So the common at all times is outputting IR. So this is good if you do have a common device that you want to control in multiple areas of the house. Otherwise, you're probably going to want to just stick with your routed IR outputs. So with that being said, let's go ahead and unravel our IR cable here. And we're going to plug in routed IR output number 1, like so. Nothing fancy about that. And then we need to find the IR receiver input on the DVD player, the Blu-ray player. I think it's right there. Oh, it's off camera for you guys, so let me raise this up a little bit. Now, I'm pretty sure it's right about here. It's hard to see. Sometimes you really have to look close, so you can usually see an opening. And I'll have to do some testing off camera just to make sure that is the right section. But we'll take our IR emitter, which has a little sticky 3M adhesive on the back. We'll remove that film. And now we can place this strategically right on the front of our Blu-ray player, like so. So now, whenever we're sending a command, it'll be no different than actually being right in front of our Blu-ray player, physically pointing the remote right here. All right, so the next thing we're going to take a look at is actually in WebConfig now. Within the MCA66 web configuration page, we're going to go to Setup, and then go to Source Settings, and we're going to edit our sources here. We're going to call source number 1 Blu-ray. We're going to edit source 1. and we're going to change the device type. Let's go ahead and choose Blu-ray. Now from here we can also choose the manufacturer type, so let's go ahead and find Panasonic since that is what we are working with today. And you'll see we have a few device codes. So there's actually quite a few in this list. I'm not sure which of these five device codes is the proper one, so I'm going to need to do a little off-camera testing and I will find the correct one. If it happens that one of these is the correct one, I can use the native IR codes right here without having to do any IR learning. And this would then allow me to go into my XTS Plus keypad, and when I hit the play button on the XTS, when I'm controlling source one, it would send that play command properly to the Blu-ray player, and the Blu-ray player will accept that command and play. If I don't have the right device code, the XTS keypad will not send the right command, and although the Blu-ray player will receive an IR command, it won't know what it is, so it won't actually play. So I'll have to find out which one of these is the proper code. If by any chance none of these codes work, I have the option of learning IR to the system, so we'll cover that in a separate video altogether for the learning capability. Alright, so we're back over here, and it turns out the first code in my list was actually the right IR code, but let me just show you now what a few things we can do. I can of course still take my original remote and point it at the Blu-ray disc player and do my eject command for open and close. That would work as expected. What about that MDK keypad though? So let's go over here and take a look real quick. I have my MDK keypad and I have source number one Blu-ray selected. If I take my remote and I point it at the MDK keypad and do the same eject command, you'll see this is actually passed through the MDK down to the MCA and out of the emitter, and of course right to the Blu-ray player. So now this is functioning with true IR pass-through. This means I can use the original remote, point it at an MDK keypad, and it will pass through to the Blu-ray player right through the MCA. So that doesn't require any learning whatsoever. It just requires that you have an IR remote, an MDK or SLK1 keypad, and a product that can be controlled via IR with an attached emitter hooked up to the proper source output for IR. That's easy enough. What about that touchscreen keypad though? This is where those codes came into play. So let's get this guy on camera here. And as you'll notice, on our XTS Plus keypad, we actually have a whole host of options on the keypad now. And this is determined based on what device type we selected, which was Blu-ray. So that's why we see all these Blu-ray related options on the keypad. It doesn't appear I have an eject button on here. We could always map one to one of the other buttons with mapping. So let's just stick with a command that we do have functional here. Let's do power. So what happens if I hit power here? We'll check it out. Blu-ray just said bye, it's powering down. So this keypad here, the XTS, it knows the right command to send through the MCA. Well, the command's actually not originally from the XTS keypad, but the button press of power is telling the MCA to send a power on command to source one. And the MCA is pulling that power on command appropriately from that IR code that we selected. So ultimately that Blu-ray player is receiving the right code for power on, and as you can see, it is turning on. So that's IR in a nutshell. Pretty helpful if you're using any type of IR device, whether that's a CD player, a Blu-ray player, cable box, a TV. And it is quite an extensive array of options you can do, especially when it comes to macro building and additional IR programming and learning. So I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for joining. Take care, everyone.